I don't know which Muslim in this country has given Dr. Swami the impression that they don't consider themselves as equal Indians. However, be that as it may, yes, sir, right in the middle. After this. The mic's not.
Thank you. Now, many languages are being spoken up there, and since Subramanian was introduced speaking four languages, I guess I not only have to say good afternoon and namaste, but also ni hao ma and malai vanakam, eppadi irukinga.
Okay, what's your question?
So, I have to make a short statement before making the question. Now, this is my first day in India, and I'm here to find out how my destiny can be tied closer together with India's. And I think this is something we all share, regardless of the religions we have. India has been the womb and the cradle for many, many religions.
What's your question, sir?
I will come to it.
To it quickly, our time is limited. Yeah?
Okay. But then my question is, I think that religions by themselves can unite people, because religions can never divide people, just like you said. They teach love, respect, tolerance, justice, all these things. The only thing that divides us is man's interpretation of religion. To claim that my religion is better than yours and therefore I have a right to kill you, rape you, torture you, many other things. So the question I'm asking now, and that you could ask yourselves, is how can we work with religion in a way so that it unites us and does not divide us? Because religion has never divided anybody.
That's not a question.
Agree.
Please sit down. Yeah.
How can we work with religion so that it starts to unite us and not divide us, is the question.
Yeah, thank you. That's a comment. Dr. Farooq Abdullah.
Thank you. Does it work?
Yeah, it's working.
Well, to Subramanian Swami, your daughter is married to a Muslim.
Yes.
My daughter is married to a Hindu. And Iqbal says, Mazhab nahi sikhata aapas mein bair rakhna. Hindi hai hum watan hai hindostan hamara. And my question to you is, why do you brush us all Muslims by the same brush by saying that we must learn that we are basically all Hindus and therefore you respect us? We respect each other, each other's religion anyway. And if it's just one country, Saudi Arabia, which behaves like that, look at the other Islamic country, Dubai, where I am going to inaugurate a Gurdwara. Can you imagine? That shows that Islam has that way of accommodation. So Islam is not bad. No religion is bad. So Swami, my question is it not true that we politicians and the religious leaders, whether here or in Pakistan, are the ones who are root cause of the tragedies that we are facing in our both nations?
Well, your question calls for a long answer, but I'll give a short answer. Politicians cannot create anything. Unless the ground reality is there, politicians cannot do anything. So, you may say what you like, this is my view. I would say this, that it's very easy to speak goody-goody things about Hindus and Muslims. I have nothing against them. After all, as I say, they are part of my family. So there's no question. But I do see that 500,000 Hindus have been driven out of Kashmir. I do see that a professor in Kerala had his hands chopped off because he had asked in an exam question something which the clerics didn't like. Well, certainly.
Please keep quiet.
Certainly. I am not going to defend any action which is taking place, where the Muslims, Hindus are engaged in any violent activity. But theologically, Hinduism doesn't preach these things. Islam, I'm only saying to the Muslim intellectuals, please declare that all religions are equal. Or all religions lead to God if you don't want to say it equal. But ours leads faster, you can say that. So, it's happening everywhere. The problem arises because there is this concept of Darul Islam, Darul Harab and Al-Zakiyah. And that psychology permeates wherever Muslims in India, in any pocket are in majority. I have found from my personal experience that the Hindu community lives in fear there. Whether it's in Kashmir, whether it's in Meerut, whether it's in Mau, whether it's in a town panchayat near Vellore, or whether it's in Kerala. In Malappuram, for example. That is because there is a different view as to what should be the shape of society where Muslims are in majority. That is what is called as Darul Islam, and that is what Saudi Arabia is. And that's what happened in Bangladesh, where there were 32% Hindus. Today it's down to 7%. It's one of the largest religious cleansing that has taken place anywhere in the world.
I think Maulana Madni wants to say.
मैं एक बात कहना चाहता हूँ, डॉक्टर सुब्रमण्यम स्वामी साहब डिक्लेरेशन चाहते हैं तो मुसलमानों के लिए सबसे बड़ी चीज, सबसे बड़ी किताब, सबसे बड़ी हिदायत की चीज कुरान है और कुरान ने बिल्कुल साफ हुक्म दे दिया लकुम दीनुकुम वलिया दीन, तुम्हारे लिए तुम्हारा दीन मुबारक और हमारे लिए हमारा दीन मुबारक, तो अलग से किसी डिक्लेरेशन की मैं तो समझता हूँ कोई जरूरत
सिरा और हदीत में तो नहीं है, सिरा और हदीत में नहीं है,
बिल्कुल है सब, जब कुरान में है तो फिर हदीस में तो जरूरत भी नहीं रहती
जी। और सवाल ले लें, जावेद मुस्तफा अंसारी राइट एट द बैक।